It seems like all of my vlogs this week are just like adventure vlogs because I'm not really doing a whole lot. Like, I'm doing a little bit of like sky studies for Patreon and accidentally edited more videos than I intended to. And then so I decided to spend the Wednesday doing an extra sketchbook slam day. Because realistically, like, if I only do this sketchbook one day a week, it would take 30 weeks, which is like over half a year. So that's just a long time. I don't know if we're gonna go camping or not because of the whole like COVID thing. It might make transportation difficult because it involves taking the ferry and people are not taking the ferries unless they live there. So hi, baby. But if I did, I would take a bunch of pieces of this with me. I don't know if it would be feasible to do sketchbook slam every day. Like, it just seems like, I know everyone did it, but like, it's just a lot. Especially when I'm like, if I'm out camping and I don't have access to anything other than what's within the closest 100 feet of me, I'm gonna get sick of drawing blades of grass from life. And I don't know if I'm imaginative enough to come up with 20 pages of a sketchbook every day within 8 hours a day. This is how it's going. I'm about this far in, y'all. I'm gonna do another one tomorrow. I was gonna do it today, but I'm too tired. So of course we went on like a super huge adventure. again, we donned our little masks and took the bus. So this marks about 2, 4, 6 days so far, even though I started it a month ago. Like, I feel really burnt out, especially after doing this section. I was doing word art, I guess, using lyrics, which I really enjoyed and I kind of want to do more of that. I might have to save that for camping though, because this is the kind of thing that I can do without reference. So, yeah, I feel bad that I don't really have anything to really say or post on social media because I feel disconnected. I think that happens when you sit at a desk a lot and just do work and work with your head down, and you look up and you think, like, what am I really gaining from this? I'm busy, like, I'm so busy, I'm burned out busy, but, like, is it really helping me? Is it getting me anywhere? Am I, like, doing anything of value? I think that's why I love the flea market so much, because it gave me something. Like, it gave me a touchstone, a place to have the opportunity to like sell things and meet new people. And without that, like, I just feel so disconnected and unable to actually find my place in the world. But yeah, John's out getting ingredients for gazpacho because it's warm and I like gazpacho when it's warm. I really like this sketchbook, by the way. Like, I just really do. I like the color of it, and I like the feel of it. Oof. Big boy. Gazpacho is pretty much just watery salsa. I don't like blending it. I like it kind of chunky, you know? Maybe I should have diced it a little smaller.
Fell in the water. Oh no.
Look at looking at his tail dog. Aaron.
Oh
hey.
I get him.
Is it not a current?
How is it doing?
Can you guess?
It's coming right for us.
sure is. She's weird.
What the heck? Not too much of interest is going on in all this, like, footage of us going outside. We've been selecting places that are hopefully not too crowded. Like, the beach one was more crowded than we were comfortable with. Like, we choose based on how big and empty the buses are to get there and how much open space there is. I'm also really curious to know if you guys have any suggestions on what to do with my YouTube channel, because it's not really growing at all. Like, I don't, like, not even just that it's growing, but it just seems like it's actually dying. I don't have a big channel, so it going down seems impossible. Or my videos are just not that interesting, which is quite likely. I try to keep them interesting for having, like, voiceovers or doing something new, or, but I also don't watch art videos from other people pretty much ever. But I know that there are people who still like those kind of videos, so I'm not sure. This isn't really like a call out or anything, but just in case, like, somebody has some kind of insight, I'm open to hearing it. And a lot of it probably has to do with my voiceovers are very low energy because I have to be quiet, being not home alone while my husband's working. So that's been a challenge, and this is the best that I can do. And I've been printing off some readily available classic lit based off of a BuzzFeed article where people were naming short stories that affected them deeply in a creepy kind of way. So I've got these. I don't know what any of them are about because I didn't take literature. I'm really excited about reading these, and also I need to come up with a new game plan. I know that I have told myself this before, but I just get caught up in all the stuff that I'm already doing with Patreon and YouTube and social media that it falls by the wayside. Because in college, the only thing that we learned about art business was to allot at least 30 minutes a day researching opportunities and places to submit art. And for the longest time, I just assumed they meant like contests and juried exhibitions and stuff, but now I'm thinking more like commercially. And I hear that a lot that will help you is pretending to do illustration jobs, right? So now that I have these stories, I can make notes and like do little practice illustrations and pretending that someone gave me the story and wanted me to illustrate it. Like, I think that that would be a good thing. Yeah, there are also websites that put you in contact with random clients online. I've already been rejected by one because it's too full. And there's a couple others, but I need to scan like my ID card and stuff like that, so I'm like kind of hesitating. So I have a commission to do, and I don't have any good watercolor paper right now, except for I have a sample of Bockingford left, and it looks like it behaves almost exactly like the I guess Strathmore, except it's like the color retention is a little bit better. But it's the same issue that I have with all the other ones, in that as soon as I get more than two layers deep, it starts to pile up on the surface and look muddy compared to the arches. So yeah, like this one is really flat. It's like, it just seems uneven and thicker in some places. And then there's this one where it's way more even, and it also is still transparent. Doesn't look muddy. It looks really nice. So, because these colors should be harmonious as well. So I don't really understand what exactly makes it so different, but it is so different. And unfortunately, I went to the Michaels, and because it's relatively nearby and I can get there, they not only don't carry any high quality stuff, it seems, but they also don't seem to be carrying any of their normal stuff. Like, I go in there and it's looking a little bit like Sears right now. Like, it's looking a little bit empty, and I don't know if they're just having difficulty getting stuff in, or if this whole shutdown thing is destroying them from the inside. So I'm a little concerned for the Michaels, and I don't really know what their angle is or what they're doing, but that sucks. So I have to go out of my way to find nice paper before I can do this commission. I don't really have time to do that, because it would take me at least 3 hours to do that. So I guess I'm not gonna be working on that commission for a little while. Luckily, it's not urgent. I'm not sure what to do, exactly.